Welcome back to another emancipation video. I wanted to make a video talking about how I moved out. I realized this is something pretty important because once you're emancipated, you probably won't live with your parents anymore. And my experience was extremely unique and distinct. So I wanted to share. Hopefully can help. So since you would still be in high school, you would first want to plan a date when you're going to move out. I wanted to move out in the middle of the school year, basically. I think it was during February, which is like smack in the middle of my junior year. And my mom didn't want me to because it doesn't really make sense, even though I really wanted to. So plan out a date where you're going to move out. Since you're in school, that would be in the summer after school ends because it won't be super ideal to move in the middle of the school year, but totally up to you. And you can make that decision since you're emancipated. I didn't exactly want to defy my mom on that, so I just listened to her reluctantly. So once you have a date planned, you would want to figure out how you're going to move. For me, my parents were both in China and I was already living on my own at my house, which is like my parents' house. I was supposed to be paying rent, but that is a whole different situation. So I had to figure out how I was going to move, and I am from New England. So I was moving from Connecticut to New York, and it's Binghamton, New York from like basically Hartford, Connecticut, which is about 4 hours if you're driving. And I moved by bus. I took Greyhound. It was a good 6-8 hours one way, like ride, I would say. I had a lot of stuff, and originally my sister was going to come with me, but she had her reasons for not being able to come that I totally understand, and I had to move by myself. So I wanted to carry 4 huge boxes and luggages with me, but my older brother was like, no, he literally did not let me. So I ended up taking probably half of my stuff. This is like an interruption. I recommend getting rid of so much of your stuff because it makes you so much lighter. It makes you feel better because you don't have as much of a burden. I think now I realize that having all of that stuff, materialistic items, it just adds to your burden and it doesn't make anything better. And if you really need, you can always buy things that you need, which is better than carrying a bunch of junk that you end up not using, which is what I was doing. So I ended up taking, I think, 3 things of luggage that were pretty heavy because I filled them very heavy. And they were over the limitations that Greyhound has for your luggage. That was not good, but they did not check. Okay, they don't check. So I was really worried about the measurements and the amount of weight that my luggage was, but they didn't even check. So I'm just like, okay. For the Greyhound buses, or any bus to say the least, they have a little compartment on the bottom right side of the bus and you just put it in. That is how I did it. So if you're gonna choose to do it the way I did, you would also need to plan your bus ticket when you're going to go. I went to New York first, so that would be the Greyhound station on 8th Avenue in New York City, Manhattan. And then I went to Binghamton, which was downtown Main Street, Binghamton, I believe. And the first one to New York City was maybe like 2 hours. The second one was over 4 hours to Binghamton. But I honestly can say I like that bus ride because it's super peaceful. So my bus ride to New York City was at 12:01 a.m. I happen to remember that. I don't know why. I wanted to get to Binghamton really early so I can like unpack and prepare. I wanted to get there super early and not get there late at night or in the middle of the day. So I took the 12:01 bus from Hartford, Connecticut to New York City. And that one was kind of packed, but like not really. It wasn't horrible. I liked it because it was dark and I just liked the vibe. You do you, so you choose which one you would want to do. And I'm just sharing what I did, honestly, because now that I think about it, I guess it's an experience that's really crazy. So I took that bus and then I waited in New York City for a good 2-4 hours, but I didn't even leave the Greyhound station. I just stayed there and was on my phone. I was completely alone through this. Please don't ask me how. I was just alone and I was 16. Then after I waited in the Greyhound station, I took the bus to Binghamton, which was kind of fun for me. And I was super tired because I didn't sleep. I've never been to the upper part of New York. So Binghamton, Rochester, Ithaca, Syracuse, Buffalo, I've never been up there. And I thought it was pretty cool to go there. I guess I should explain why I chose Binghamton. Now that I think about it, there isn't a specific reason why. It's just because I knew I wanted to go to a SUNY college. The college I go now is a SUNY school. They pay me to go here basically. So that makes me really happy because I don't have a burden and it's a good school, relatively good school, good location. It meets a lot of my preferences for college, which is great. Binghamton has a SUNY school, which is the University of Binghamton, and I wanted to be a business major. They have a super good business school, so that's part of it. Another thing is I did not want to crush myself with $1,000 of rent for each month. That was not something I wanted to do, so that was also a reason. It's very affordable, but that also means more problems, like different situations that you might have to deal with. I worked at McDonald's, so I guess you guys can't imagine what I dealt with my first year living alone. I can definitely make more parts to this because it's just so many different aspects that I didn't realize to this whole journey. But I think Binghamton, living there, it taught me to kind of see things, I guess, in a different light because I've never really dealt with a place like that. I grew up in like a suburban town off like the city, near the city, so it's like very different for me to move to Binghamton. It's super convenient. I lived 5 minutes away from my high school walking, so I would wake up pretty much right when class starts to go to class. And I was a senior, so I had a strong diagnosis of senioritis. I did not care. I was crushed with work and I was so exhausted all the time. It was bad. Plus, I had some bad relationships with food, and that was my lowest point in my health ever. I lost my period for like a good amount of time. I'm not gonna share how long. You guys just need to know that it wasn't the best part of my life. And now that you guys can see vlogs of my life now, you can definitely see the fact that there's always light at the end of the tunnel. Okay, you're gonna go through what you're gonna go through, and then you're gonna come out of it stronger than ever, and you're gonna have a much brighter life, better experiences, amazing things to be grateful for, which is me right now.